Who is Tato Mohlala?
Hey, Tato. This is going to change your life forever. Congratulations, you're the captain of the first team.
Well, Tato Mohlala, that's all your father left you. His money and the company. Congratulations, young man. Your future looks impressive.
I guess I should call you Mr. Mohlala from now on.
You should.
Tato! Tato! Can I help you? Yeah, yeah, lighty. Got some merchandise for you. My father's just sold us. Ran this whole operation. Now it's all yours for the taking.
Does that look like drugs?
No, man. Drugs is such a harsh word. Father called them refreshments. That's what your father used to call them.
So, man, I don't know who you are or what this is all about, but my father was no drug lord.
Hey, don't walk away from your father's legacy. This is what he would have wanted for you.
Hey, where were you?
It was changing, sir.
You let the team down again. See Leroy over there? He's the next captain. You're out. Go.
What?
Go.
Him?
You're out.
A shame. And you're here because, you know what? Don't answer that. Listen, you left, so I left you. I'm now with Leroy. He might think it the biggest thing to happen to the school, but you're not.
No. Yes, Ntuli, you're just like everybody else. You all expect me to be what you think I am, what you want me to be. What about what I want? Yazini, I finally realized who I am, and impelile yonke lonto. Had enough of it.
Taku, you are late. Please complete this bursary application form, the one for performing arts that I've told you about. The due date is just around the corner.
Why can't you just let me be? Why do you keep meddling? Maybe I am my father's son after all. And maybe it's time I started acting like it. Take your stupid bursary form application. I don't need it.
Ixe, Jojo, I'll do it. I'll take over my father's business. But first, there's something I need you to sort out for me. There's this idiot, Leroy. I need you to take care of him. Teach him a lesson. I'll send you his details. Destiny makes its own choices.
Good morning, boys and girls. We received some tragic news today.
One of our scholars was killed in a motor car accident over the weekend. He settled down. We were devastated to lose Lira Anderson, one of our brightest stars, especially on the rugby field.
This is not what I wanted. I didn't want him dead. It's all gone wrong.
You will now go to your register classes where your teachers will advise you further.
I know that you are upset about the passing away of one of our learners, but maybe it's a good time to reflect on the opportunities that you still have and that you can make the most of in your lives.
It's all gone wrong. I was supposed to be this big hero, and now I'm the villain.
But it's not your fault, Doctor. And besides, it's not just bad news. You remember the performing arts bursary? Well, I completed it on your behalf because it was just too good an opportunity to miss. And they phoned me earlier today to say that you have been accepted into the program.
But you don't understand. I'm not what you think I am.
Come in.
Good morning, Mrs. Brown. Sorry to disturb you. We have a very urgent matter to attend to. Please point out the person, Mr. Phillips.
Zylite, Tato, sit me up. He's on the solicitation. Tato Mustalo.
You are under arrest for the murder of Leroy Anderson. You have the right to remain silent. Anything that you say will be held against you in a court of law. Come with me.
Something.
What it looks like.
Who am I? And what is this path I find myself on? Not one more rugby practice, or one more note of song. Instead,
all is silent. Maybe I am like Macbeth, and it was vaulting ambition that got the better of me. Or like Othello, being made jealous, my love turned to revenge. But where I'm going, none of that matters. Destiny, did I have no say in you? Or was I a fool for believing that others held all my cards? And then my heart started.